War II History. Michael's in Deerfield Beach, Florida. Hi, Michael.
Yes, hi. Wow, you guys are always so amazing. Reagan was so amazing because of his popularity. I think it was his positive conservatism, which, unfortunately, in my opinion at least, I'm a Democrat, is the same as Trump. But Trump is different, and Reagan was a chimera, but I think it needs a more precise metaphor, which would be a slushy. A slushy needs a precise temperature control, otherwise it's solid, it's ice, or it's liquid. And that's not a good slushy. And Reagan had a sense of that. In other words, what I mean by ice is it's a balance between like positivism, group interest, and abundance versus fear, a mindset of scarcity, and self-interest. Now, right now, in our current context with Trumpism, we're seeing that as a battle, a mortal battle in some cases, one versus the other. And what he had a sense of is that what's important is that it needs governance, it needs temperature control. And steam engines, they used to blow up, and they created this thing that was a governor. The governor is actually something which is our social context, which is getting this neurobiology there. It's called PACES.
Hey, Michael, before we get too deep there, very quickly, you're a fan of Ronald Reagan and not so much of Donald Trump. Is that correct?
Correct. Thank you,
sir. Let's hear from Craig Shirley.
Thank you, Michael, for your call and your interest. I'm in that same camp myself. As a fan of Reagan, somebody who worked for Reagan, somebody who grew to admire Reagan, and less an admirer of Donald Trump, although Donald Trump did not have very good policies. He had a very good story to tell as president of the States, whether it's what he did in the Middle East or how he revived the economy or his handling of COVID and the vaccination and all the other issues, deregulation. There are some issues that I take issue with him at. And I take issue, too, with his personal behavior as far as the what he said and the comments he made, which weren't always, in my opinion, very presidential. And those affected his legacy. So it's still to be determined, I think. We need to let the ground cool before we rationally address it. But was his presidency simply a
he committed
time,
Trump COVID genocide? Do you understand that? More than 600,000 people died needlessly because he made it a public policy, a public policy to promote herd genocide. Herd genocide is not the same as just herd immunity. To promote natural herd immunity is what he made public policy, okay? Natural herd immunity is the same as giving smallpox blankets to the population and let it spread naturally, okay? That's what he did. He literally, this is not a metaphor, it's the dictionary definition of the word genocide, to promote a public policy of natural herd immunity. Will you let it run through the population? The man has committed mass murder. He will go down in history because it wasn't just him. He engendered an authoritarian attitude and regime in multiple countries where this has also happened. And it affected even those countries that seemed to do relatively well. They only did the Western countries relatively well compared to genocidal countries. The Western countries as a group are all guilty, almost equally, because they accepted the genocidal maniac, because even though we do need to create peace, which was my point, and understand that we need to focus on needing both of those two dichotomous, neurologically programmed, biological, it's part of our biology. Every social species has a right or a left or an inside or an outside or a front or back in their physical structure of their brain that enables one side to focus on group.